Hi SV friends, so today the verse that we are going to meditate on is from Galatians chapter 2 verse 20. It says, I have been crucified with Christ and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. So when we accept Christ, we have been crucified with Christ and we no longer live. It is Christ who lives in us. So I was just explaining about this verse to my kids. Usually when in their bedtime, we talk something, and some days I encourage them with some thing that I learned from reading the Bible. And one day when we were talking about it, I was explaining them about this verse. So they have their teddy bears. This is Anya.
And this is Elsia.
Elsia. So they sleep with them every night. Everywhere they go, they carry them around. And they've been having, how many years are you having them?
I think six.
So 6 years they've been having these teddy bears, and they don't leave them anywhere. They carry them around. So I was explaining about this verse to them. And I was telling them how this Anya, she has no life in there. She's just by herself. But who gives life for Anya? It's Liana. So Liana gives the voice. Liana gives decides the character of Anya. So if Anya is good, that means Liana is good. If Anya behaves bad, that means Liana is behaving bad, right? So that's what I was telling them. So this is like us. They have no life in there, but you are like God. God gives life for Anya. So when we have God in us, they're going to be reflecting good, right? So that's what I explained to them. They really loved it and they understood. So I thought I will use this illustration to explain to you guys as well. So we need to have Christ living in us, like how Anya and Elsie are, like, you know, they don't have life in there. We have been crucified with Christ when Christ died for us. So it is no longer we who live, it is Christ who lives in us. So sometimes, you know, we try to do things of our own self. We want to be good. We want to know everything out of our own strength. We try to achieve things. But a lot of times we become disappointed with trying to be that good, trying to please God on our own strength. You know, the Bible says God is almighty. He is a mighty God. It's not that he has some might. It's not that he has some love. Or it's not that he has some peace that we need some of it. Lord, give me some love that I can love this person. Or give me some peace today. No. He himself is almighty. He himself is love. He himself is peace. So when he lives in us, we have the peace. And we have God's power. And we have the peace and the love. We are saved because Christ lives in us. So we don't need, first point I want to say is we don't need self-improvement. We need self-replacement. We don't want to improve ourselves. We need to replace ourselves with Christ. So the second point that I want to say is about the tree of life and tree of knowledge. So what happened in the Garden of Eden? Satan came, and what did he do?
He deceived them.
He told his lie. You know, what did he say? It's for God knows that in the day you eat from it, your eyes will be open and you will be like God, knowing good and evil. It's you knowing. It's you. It's all about you there. You know, it's not about God. You will be all knowing. Your eyes will be open. And you'll be knowing what is good and evil. Now, that has become so much of about us, humanism. It's all about us, what I think. We try to reason out what is right and what is wrong. You know, today we have in Christianity, it's like more than 2,300 denominations. Why? Because we decide what is right, what is wrong, what is good, what is evil. We decide with our own reasoning. Did God intend for it? No. He wanted us to be one, you know, in reflecting him. But we have so many denominations, so many difference in opinion, so many reasoning, just because
we try to live out of our own mind. So we need to leave the, you know, not live by tree of knowledge, tree of life. Okay. So our reasoning and everything is from the tree of knowledge. That is what Adam and that is what Satan intended for us. But God intended us for us to live by tree of life. What is tree of life? You know, we read from John 15, the branches, it abides in the vine, and that's when the branches bear fruit, right? So who is the vine there? That's God, and we are the branches. We need to be abiding in Him so we can grow and bear fruit. So that is the tree of life. So let's not try to live by tree of knowledge, where we try to reason, we try to do things on our own, we try to learn all theology, but we don't act on it. We don't live how God wants us to live. We don't live how Christ lives in us and reflecting Christ through us. So we need to be abiding in the vine and bear fruit, and we'll be the branches that will be bearing fruit for God. So from today, let's just decide that we don't live, reflect ourselves, but reflecting God. Let's ask God to come and abide in us, live inside us, so He'll be revealed. So Anya and Elsia, so we are like these Anya and Elsia living in God's hands. So we do what God wants us to do and not what we want to do, right? Okay. So we're going to sing this small chorus, sing along, and every day, every minute, every hour, we need God, right? So that's how we reflect Christ. Let's just sing this song. Lord, I need You.
Lord, I need You.
God, that He will come and live inside us, right? Most gracious Father, thank You for this time that You gave us. Lord, I pray that You will come and live inside us, that we would reflect You. It is no longer us, Lord, but You living in us, and Lord, be revealed through us, Father. We give You all the glory and honor and praise, Lord. Pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Bye.